Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Hello and welcome to Game Time, Hotshot. We are playing NBA Jam on the Super Nintendo from 1995. This game, to coin a phrase, was my jam back when I was a wee toddler. I loved this title. This is the kind of thing that got me into basketball. Used to be a huge fan of the NBA, and I'm getting back into it recently. And of course, the Miami Heat just won the NBA Finals in 7 games over the San Antonio Spurs. So I thought I would recreate some of that magic using an 18-year-old video game. I already played one game just to get back into the controls and remember how this game works. But let's pick up where I left off. I've already defeated Dallas. The game has a set number of opponents. You go in order, kind of tournament style. So I'm going to play as the Miami Heat. Let's just pretend that that black bald guy minor there is LeBron James, because let's just face it, he's obviously not the white guy with the unibrow. And we got, look, his three-pointers and dunks, and it's going to be great. And we are playing the Minnesota Timberwolves. So, I don't know, pretend they're the Spurs. This will be fun, though. It's just quick, really basic, two-on-two basketball, and I'm looking forward to it. So you can do turbo, you can steal the ball, you can slam into him, and you can rebound. And come on, catch it. Yes, all right, so I can pass to this guy. Oh, yeah. Take the shot. Oh, we missed it. Get on the floor. Get on the floor. Jerk. Ooh, he stuffed that one in there. All right, come on, white guy. Let's move it. Quick pass it to LeBron. Oh, it's stolen. It's all out of bounds. Oh, it just sits there. That was kind of strange, but... Whoa, boom, shakalaka. That was great. Get out of the way, Timberwolves. Do the Timberwolves even exist anymore? I feel like I think they exist, but I think they got a new logo since 95. A lot of things have changed in the NBA since I started watching. Used to go to Celtics games all the time. Back when they lost, it was depressing. The 90s were not a great time for Boston sports. None of the four teams won any championships. And in comparison to the 2000s, where they all won at least once, yeah, the 90s were kind of a rough time to be a Boston sports fan. None of the teams were really good at all. The Celtics, really kind of terrible. Oh my goodness, he went off of the screen! All right, we're tied 8-8. Get out of here! Oh, what? How is that not a technical foul? That is... Jerkwad. He's going to the hoop! Oh, he slams it down! Oh. You know what happened before this game? I was able to touch the Space Jam basketball, and that's how I have all these special powers right now. He jams it in! There's not a lot of processing power. What the fuck? Little piece of shit. Hook shot! Oh, and it goes wide! He's hitting up! Alright, fine. I don't care. Another dunk! This game is really just a series of running back and forth and dunking, and then occasionally getting a steal. There's not a lot of strategy involved. There's not a lot of, like, teamwork. I mean, you can pass it, but it's honestly not even, like, all that important. Oh! 3 points! Oh, wait, I'm still down by one. And that's how we end the first quarter. I was about to say, having the actual speech was a big deal in 95 for the Super Nintendo. Let's read this tip first. Physical play. Clear an opponent out of the way by pressing the turbo and steal buttons at the same time. All right, that's good to know. Thanks for that tip. Second quarter begins now. 2 minutes and 30 seconds on the clock. And here we go. Oh, yes! Oh, he's going to it! Boom! And the Heat take the lead. Oh, wait, it's 3 minute quarters, not 2:30. I knew they were shorter. I didn't know about how much, though. Oh, this is gonna be easy peasy Japanesey. He's on fire. Literally burned the netting. Oh. Yeah, but for Super Nintendo games, having actual speech, that was a big deal. Like, these games did not have a lot of memory or hard drive space or hardware, whatever you want to call the technology. I don't know what the correct term would be. But they didn't, there was, you know, they were very technically limited, these old 8-bit Super Nintendo cartridges. So to actually have human speech say things like from downtown, that was like, whoa, man, did you see the new NBA Jam game, man? They actually have people talking in it, it's awesome! So, like, when I was, like, 9 years old playing this, I was kind of blown away by, like, how awesome this game was. And this game, I'm sure the word was not generated from this title. What the fuck was that? I don't think the phrase was coined by NBA Jam 95, but I do believe that NBA Jam popularized the phrase Boom Shock Alaka, which you know is one of my all-time favorites. It's good! Oh my goodness! Get out of the way! Get out of the way! Oh my goodness, that was from the foul line almost. Just gonna go right in for it. A little pussy little layup, jerkwad. I wish I knew who these players were so I can make more pointed insults at their careers, but I'll be completely honest. I was a huge fan of the NBA in 1995, but I could not tell you anybody on the Timberwolves or the Heat from that era, because let's face it, 95, all the rage was on Michael Jordan and the Bulls. No one really cared about any other team because he was dominating so badly. So greatly, I mean. That was weird. Yes! The Heat take a 2-point lead late in the second quarter. That was uncalled for. All right, here we go. We're going. I'm just going to put it in. You can just turbo past everybody and... No, he's going to get a shot at it. Shit! Oh, we go into halftime down by 1 point. We have to get back at these Timberwolves. They're wolves that like to eat wood. Who doesn't? Here's the halftime report. He's wearing a Bulls jersey. He's very clearly wearing a Bulls jersey. And that was definitely Scottie Pippen on the bottom right. And I am positive Scottie Pippen did not play for the Timberwolves in 1995. Like, 100% on that. All right, so here's a breakdown. 12 points went to LeBron James and 24 points over to Sexcali there. And the Timberwolves, a little bit more evenly split, 15 and 22. Actually, no, it wasn't more evenly split. It's actually kind of the same. Let's get back into the action here and see if we can take them back in the second half. All right, Sexcali, pass it over. LeBron James goes to the hoop. For two. Oh, and he misses it. Oh, how terrible. Just like the real LeBron. When you really need him, he's not there. Oh, what?
Silence the critics. King James is in the house.
Oh, he stole it and then passed right back to the Timberwolves. That was a Manu Ginobili move. Oh, John. Sorry, San Antonio fans. I had to go for that one. Oop! I love those just wussy little layups. What? God, Jesus, I did it again. Things are happening so quickly. They're happening so quickly that I completely lose track of what's going on and pass it to the enemy. All right, I got a 3-point shot there. The white guy is really good at 3-pointers. Oh! Oh, what? Fine. Be a jerk. I don't care. Whoa. What's this? Can I 3-point it? You bet I can. Wow, he's terrible. It's so quiet. There's no, like trash talking or... What is this guy doing? What is he doing? Why can't I change controllers? What's going on? I don't know what just happened. That was kind of a weird thing just happened. The game's tied, though, with a minute going to the third quarter here. Howard Cosell with your ABC Sports broadcast. Wait a second! I am actually broadcasting on a sport I have expertise in. What a wonderful thing this has happened. Brought back from the dead, and I am actually useful because I know what I'm talking about. And coincidentally, these players were alive when I was too. So this is great. I feel like I'm right back at home broadcasting for the NBA on NBC. Back to you in the studio. Thanks, Howard. Always a pleasure to have you on Game Time, especially when you're doing things that you actually did when you were alive. Yes, I know. It is fantastic. Foul him! Foul him! Oh, jerk. I got 2 seconds. Gonna run? Throw the ball! What? That was pathetic! Tied after 3 quarters. Miter and Sexcali going up against Latnier and that other dude. Jump shot pass. Press and hold the shoot button, then press the pass button. This allows you to dish off to your opponent teammate. What? Huh? What? I read that wrong. John, go back to school. You're illiterate. Yes, I know. I'm very embarrassed by it. All right, here we go. Fourth quarter. Now we got to get all the stops out. Quick, just foul him. I want to hear the coach's speech between quarters. Just foul the shit out of him. Oh, he takes it to the rim. All right, 49-49. Kind of a low-scoring affair. But that's all right. We just have to be the last person with the ball. I think that's all that is really necessary here. I'm just going to go right to the hoop with this one. Because that has proven to be a very high percentage shot. The turbo dunk. You hold L and R to get the turbo in this game, and it's pretty fantastic when you finally get it in. Here we go! Here we go! Another one! Wow, he just did a 720! That was incredible! Some sort of superhero feat there. Okay, here we go. Yes!
Boom, he slams it in, and the Heat take a 2-point lead.
Come on, get out of here. Yes! Oh, I don't have any turbo left! Oh, Jesus, that's what happens when you don't have turbo. What the? Oh, what a jerk. Okay, he took that from outside the paint. That's absurd. We have 90 seconds left. Gonna go for the 3-pointer. Put this game away. Oh, no. Let's go for the easy 2. All right. Good work, Sexcali. The fuck? Yes, it was. Oh, it was an alley-oop. It wasn't an air ball. An alley-oop. Woohoo! Swish. Come on. No, 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 no! Oh, what? I blocked a dunk! I didn't even know that was possible!
Suck on the rim, jerk!
Get out of here! Get out of here! Timberwolves! Suck a lemon! Alright, we got a 1-point lead. Gotta put this one away. 3 points shot! Oh no! I missed it! Damn it! Get the ball! Get the ball! Get it! Get it! Don't let him shoot! Jeez, get the ball! Get the ball! You fools! Get the ball! Oh, 7 seconds left. This is gonna be close. Heat down by one. Scalilli takes it down court, passes back to a wide open LeBron James, who takes a shot at the buzzer. He gets it in, and the Heat win by 2! That was an NBA Finals finish for you right there. Miami Heat over the Timberwolves. LeBron James with 31 points, Skakely with 33, besting the efforts of Latner and Person of the Minnesota Timberwolves. 64-62 is your final here on Game Time, and what a game it was. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.